Hello! Today I'm going to show you how to get the most out of Ableton with your Erae 2. This video is both for beginners and advanced users, as I'll take my time to show you how to use your Erae 2 in Ableton in perfect synergy. Here is a summary of this video. If you already are an advanced Ableton user, knowing how to route your controllers and tracks and how to create racks, you can go to point number 5. In Ableton, we're going to go into Settings. Then, in the MIDI section, we're gonna select the Erae 2 in both Input and Output. Under, there's the Input section, from the outside of the software to the inside, and Output, from the software to the outside. The Input port, we're gonna check Track, Sync, and Remote for the Erae 2 and the Erae 2 MPE. For the last one, we're also gonna check MPE. Track will let Ableton and the Erae 2 communicate MIDI data between them. Sync is related to the transport section. In other words, it let them be at the same tempo. Remote will let your Erae 2 control different parameters in Ableton like track, volume, pan, etc. Now your Erae 2 is all set in Ableton. Let's see how to map your Erae to an instrument. We're going to start with Operator. Here I'll be able to select the MIDI source. I have Erae 2 MIDI and Erae 2 MPE, or 3 in Windows. Erae 2 is a classic MIDI instrument. Just underneath, we'll be able to select from 16 different MIDI channels. And those channels are the same shown in this section of the Erae Lab. I want to set up an MPE instrument, so I select Erae 2 MPE, and in the Erae Lab, I drag and drop a keyboard that I resize by holding Shift and Stretch to have a 2-octave keyboard. I click on the MPE box to activate MPE. I can now play Operator. First, I'm going to right-click on Operator here and hit Group. This puts a virtual instrument in a virtual rack, so I can macro manage it by clicking on this icon. These are macro controls. They will let me see in the blink where my different parameters are. You can change the number of micros by clicking those plus and minus buttons. Operator has 4 oscillators, A, B, C, and D. I want to be able to link the levels of the oscillators to the first row of macros. To do so, I just right-click on the level section of the oscillators and I send it to macro 1. I'll do the same for the other 3. Now, when I move this macro, I can see the mapped parameters move. Now, we'd like to control these macros with the Erae. Let's add a 1D fader. The default settings of the faders are what I'm looking for, so let's not touch it. It is simply going to set a value from 0 to 127. Operator has a color scheme that will help me not lose track of my controls. Oscillator A is yellow, B turquoise, C purple, and D orange. I'd like my first fader to be yellow, so I'll go in the Style section of the Erae Lab, select the bar, and tune it to yellow. I'll do the same for the other 3. A really important shortcut is Command or Control M. It makes Ableton go into this view, where all the buttons and values in purple can be linked to an element. So let's click on the parameter I want to affect, macro 1, and then on my Erae, I'll tap on an element. Now I can control the macro with my fader. It starts to look like something. But the synth is pretty dry and simple for now, and I'd like to add some reverb and a chorus. We'd like to control them, so let's add them to the macros. This time, we'll use the 2D fader. The 2D fader is 2 faders at once. We have the X axis, which means horizontal, with minimum value at the left and maximum value at the right. Then we have the Y axis, where the max value is at the top. I'll do Command M again and tap on my 2D fader. I'll click the mapping button and just have to scroll to the gestures I want to map to the macro and activate it. If it's already active, I'll just deactivate it and reactivate it again. Now, we can control the macros with the 2D fader. I'd like to have control over Ableton directly on my Erae 2 to make my workflow smoother. Often, I'd like to be able to play, stop, launch record and tap tempo in Ableton directly when I enter a session. To do so, I use 4 buttons. A green one for play, a grey one for stop and a red one for record. Another one, in yellow, is placed underneath and is linked to tap tempo. For the buttons to have the behavior I'm looking for, I'll set the buttons to Control Change and check the On Control Change. Now, I do Command or Control M again, click on Macro and tap my button. Now, I can launch play, stop, record and tap tempo. To save the assignations I just made, I can go to Settings and click on Save Live Set as Default Set. Now, each time I launch Ableton, everything will be set up and ready to be controlled. Sometimes we want specific instruments to act differently. A velocity-less drums for them to always kick hard, or a different pressure for your pads to trigger affixes. This is exactly what I'd like to do here. I'd like the pitch of my oscillator to go an octave up, and once this octave is reached, I'd like it to blend with another synth. Let's call this the velocity divergence. There is different ways to achieve it, but the simplest is to use the expressive control module included in Ableton. The expressive module will let you map a gesture to a parameter. This module shows on the left 5 different pages. On each you can select the source, pitch bend, pressure, velocity, etc. Select the target, and in the middle, there's the curve. The x-axis represents the pressure I put on my Erae. The y-axis is the value sent to another synth. With a standard linear curve, just like that, it is pretty simple. When I'm at pressure x, x goes to the mapped parameter. When I start to tweak the curve, I can, for example, simulate an on-off switch by going from 0 to max in a really short margin. This curve means that at a certain point, the value sent by my Erae is translated to max. I'll send this parameter to the pitch of my oscillators A and B. Now, we can hear it go higher when I pass this threshold. I'll now use the chain function. This is really useful if I want to create an instrument with multiple synths. I'll use Meld as my second instrument. I'll tweak it a little bit to have the sound that I want. Okay, now I'd like Meld to be heard only when I already passed the threshold of the pitch variation. To do so, I'll use another expression module that will be placed above the instruments. In the middle of this cross is my cue. I'll do a linear curve after this point and link it to the master of Meld. The same curve will affect the volume of operator. Only it will be inverted, so as Meld mix goes up, operator's mix goes down. It will play like so. To send a message, first add a MIDI track. In this MIDI track, go to Output and select Erae 2. Add a MIDI clip. On the bottom left, select the Extended MIDI Clip view. There, you'll find 3 values: Bank, Sub, and Program. The Erae will respond to 2 kinds of messages, both coming from Bank 128. Sub will be layout changes. You can choose which layout you want to go to with the program value. 1 for layout 1, 2 for layout 2, up until layout 8. The message will be sent to the array when the playhead passes the MIDI event. To change the project during the course of a song, it's still bank 128, sub 3, program 1 for project 1, program 2 for project 2, etc. Now you know pretty much everything you need to create in Ableton with Erae 2. If you have any more questions, leave a comment down below. See you soon!